How is a clipper hone like a lampshade? Let me show you, explained. Now, the clipper hone may look flat, like a flat disc. Let me take the lid off of this so you can see what I'm talking about. So, this may appear perfectly flat. And that's why people that don't understand about how clippers are made and clipper blades are made, they may think you can sharpen. You'll see a lot of YouTube videos about this where they're sharpening on a like a stone or a hone or maybe a flat hone the way I did originally before I knew about how clippers are made or clipper blades are made. And they're doing this kind of a surface pattern. There's a hollow inside the blade. So this plate, instead of being flat like it appears, it's really cone shape, like a lampshade. Now it's a very small taper. The taper will vary from one manufacturer to another. But let me explain why having that cone shape makes a difference on your blades. So if I take a ruler and I lay it straight from the center to the outside, it's going to be perfectly flat. You're not going to see any light underneath it if my plate's in good shape. Same thing with a lampshade. If I lay this here, well, excuse the little seams here, but if I am totally straight from the center to the bottom, there's no light showing underneath my my ruler here. Do you see that? There's no light under the ruler. If I do a slight tilt, now there's light under my ruler. If I do a complete tilt where I'm going this way, well, it's definitely not flat. So if I was sharpening this way, I would create a roundness in the bottom of my blade. That's exactly what's happening here. There is a slight hollow or concave in your blades, and if you don't sharpen them with them perfectly straight, this least little angle off, do you see how that makes a difference? You don't sharpen them perfectly straight, you're not going to get the correct hollow. And can you see how the hollow will vary to where you're toward the center or you're toward the outside? So if you need a blade that has less hollow to it, and we'll talk about that later, the circumstances on that, you want to do more of your sharpening out here. If you're wanting something with a little bit more of a concave or a hollow to it, you're going to do more of your sharpening there. And there's an area some sharpeners will call a sweet spot. It's kind of controversial, but where you're going to have the most correct hollow. And the hollow, from what I hear and what I understand, is like 57 microns. So you're talking about basically, you know, hairs on your head all change from one person to the other. But basically, the width of your hair is about what the curvature or the hollow of the blade is. I know that's complicated. I'll have other little YouTube videos about it. But for now, just know, to sharpen your clipper blades correctly, you have to have a cone shape, correctly tapered hone. If you try to follow the YouTube videos where they're sharpening them on something flat, or they're using grit between the blades, or they're doing them on their flat hones, I've seen sharpeners do that. If you're doing any kind of a flat surface, you might be able to get away with one sharpening, maybe on a little cheaper, you know, trimmer blade or whatever, but pretty soon you're going to change that, you're going to change that curvature of the blade. And can you see how, if you take your fingers and you do this, and then you put them together like that, you're going to feel a difference in the friction and in the drag. So you actually would want your blades to have a slight curve so that it's at the tips where it's cutting. It's just a more efficient way. So as you take down that hollow and incorrect sharpening, you're going to get more of a drag, more friction, more heat, and eventually your blades are just not going to cut. So, yes, you've got to have the right equipment. Doesn't necessarily need to be this brand, but you need to have a machine that is designed specifically for doing clipper blades. And I'm not the little small ones that you're going to see from on Amazon that have like a little round thing. You got to have a big enough plate in order to get that. The smallest I've seen that work effectively is like the little red machine, which is 10 inches. And that one you do, it's a little bit harder to use. You have to charge it more. We'll talk about charging later. And you have to have it resurfaced more often. But it is smaller. So if you're on a budget and you're only doing maybe hair salons, or you need to sharpen on site, the little red will work well for you. I really encourage my sharpeners that are wanting to get into clipper blades to get the bigger machine. This one happens to be a 16-inch wheel. 14-inch wheel is standard. 16-inch, if you can afford a little bit more, it's definitely worth it. I get a better movement and I get better results on my blades. If you want to know more about blades, blade sharpening, shear sharpening, all things sharp for beauty shops, barber shops, groomers, please subscribe and stay tuned to my channel.